Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is Amin with Sira Masters, developing the Muslim mindset for success. Now, obviously, to develop your mindset, as I said in the podcast, check in the description. As I said in the podcast, in order to truly develop, I don't know how you can seriously do that without reading books. Okay, so let's jump into a quick book review this week. It's the book called Switch. It's by Chip and Dan Heath. These two genius brothers. Every book they put out, I love it. What do they cover? What topics do they cover? Generally, you could say the subjects that they've covered are all about human change. How do you change? How do you influence people as well? And basically, behavioral psychology. Okay, so they have quite a few books. They just put one out recently called Moments. But this one, Switch, I believe is my favorite. Switch is about how do you change things, right? How do you convince people they need to change? How do you motivate people to change? How do you allow them to see it's possible to change? And the whole concept, the whole framework they use for this book is of the rider on the elephant, okay? So the elephant, it's your kind of impulsives, your impulsive desires. It's your inbuilt desires. You want to sleep more, 5 minutes more. You want to eat more than you should. These kind of things, okay? Your desires. That's your the elephant. Now, the elephant's strong, okay? The elephant's strong. It's walking down the path, and that's your desires. It's pretty powerful. Then you got the driver on the top, the rider, sorry. The rider is your intellectual side of things, your rational side of things. And the elephant is also the more emotional side of things. So you got the rational side, who is the rider, you got the elephant, who is the emotional, and then the third element of this is the path, right? Which is the environment in which the rider is on the elephant. Now, as they say in the book, there is no way that the rider can just kick the elephant into going the direction he wants it to go. No, the elephant is huge, it's strong, it will resist, it will always win. Okay, and likewise, the elephant is the animal. Elephant is not making the decision of where it's going to go, and you know it knows the direction, and the rider is not going to just leave it alone and to go in random directions. Okay, and so the whole idea of the book is they have a section on how do you control the rational mind, how do you influence the rational mind to change and see change, and then how do you affect the emotional mind to change. And then how do you put the path in place, the environment in place to allow change to happen? And each of these sections has loads of examples, loads of stories, and it is just amazing. What I love about it is that it deals with the rational side, but it also deals with the emotional side, which is so key for most of us. That is the tough bit. Most of the time we see the logic in things, but we still don't take action. And that's what they mention in the book. There needs to be a way that you can emotionally connect to people to communicate why change needs to happen. Now, I'll try and remember some of the stories they give, but the stories are the main show here. It's the main thing to enjoy when reading this book is all the cool examples they bring. So I remember one example was in a factory, I believe they were wasting equipment because they're only using it once and throwing it out. No, I remember, sorry. They had a factory, there were loads of different factories all over the US, I think, and each one had different gloves that they were using in the factory, which means that each factory was ordering from different suppliers, which means they're wasting money. Someone was trying to change this. They wanted to save money, be more effective. But the rational side of the people wouldn't listen. They were saying, you know, it's fine, blah, blah, blah. They're not just not convinced. Okay, what do you do? I mean, I'm sure you know the situation where logically it makes sense, but emotionally people are not invested. So what did this guy do? He went to every factory and he got a pair of gloves. Now each glove looks slightly different. And he got all these different types of gloves and he dumped them in the office of the decision maker. He said, look, this is how many types of gloves we're using. Isn't this nuts? And the guy looks at all these gloves. It's manifested now in front of him and he says, yeah, that's crazy. Okay, so that's one example of how sometimes you have to represent something visually. He didn't get all the gloves. He got a representation of the gloves, a little taster, and he showed it visually. right? And this is where, for example, some people, their whole job is how to communicate statistics in a powerful way through graphs and all of that stuff. You know, it's a very good skill to have. Another story was, I think it was the UN, they sent a group of people to, I want to say, Laos, right, in Southeast Asia. And there was a malnutrition crisis there. So they went to discover what they can do to help these kids stop being, you know, malnourished and have a good diet. So they try here and there. They got all these standard things that the UN does all over the world that apply to every country. And they're trying to do this. And it turns out it wasn't working, okay? The kids still didn't have a very kind of balanced diet, okay? They were eating, I think, loads of rice, but not eating much of anything else. So what did they do? They did something called bright spotting, which I use nearly every day now. Bright spotting is looking for what's already working, looking for examples of what's already working, and then taking that and applying it elsewhere, okay? So looking for the bright spots, okay? So they found that some of the mothers in this village, they would make rice and they would get some of these shellfish and they would cook them and mix them with the rice, and that's how they would get fish into the diet of the children. And this was something which had been going on in this country for ages, and it was something very normal, but a lot of the women, they didn't know about the fish or they didn't know how to cook it or whatever. So what they started doing is, they get the women who are already doing it to teach the others how to make it, where you find these fish, how you cook it, all of this stuff. Once they did that, the kids started eating fish, eating the rice, eating other stuff that they taught them how to mix in. All of a sudden, their diet is way more balanced. Okay, so how did they do that? They did it through bright spotting. What's already working? How can we apply that on a wider scale? Okay, so these are the kind of stories that you hear when reading this book. Again, just the framework is there. And every chapter has takeaways of how you could use it in a school, how could you could use it as a teacher, in a business, in an organization, in a charity. It is a really good book. And so I just wanted to give you a bit of an insight into the framework of it with those three factors, three parts, and then also a taste of what kind of stories they bring you, and as well as how practical the book is. I would recommend it. It's in my top 10 books. Obviously it is really my type of book, so that's why I love it so much. But if you're slightly intrigued by this idea of behavior change, I think it's a great book, one of the best books on this. It's taking science and taking scientific studies and making it easy to digest. You know, it's not as dense as a like a journal paper or whatever. Then they've got their other books in case you're interested. So they recently released one called Moments, which is about how do you make amazing moments that are kind of life-changing events in people's lives. Then they've got Decisive, so how to make decisions, which I haven't read yet, but I've got it here. They've got Made to Stick, which is about how do you make these messages or stories that stick in people's minds and that they spread around and they go viral kind of thing. And then they've got Switch, and I believe they got one more, which I can't remember right now. So Chip and Dan Heath, really good authors. This is a good book. I want to recommend it to you in this video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.